Hi, everybody. It's Pat Beaupre Becker, certified weight and life coach, and I'm here to talk to you today about hunger, the different kinds of hunger. And I want to start with this idea that our brains are really, obviously, they're crucial to everything we do, but we do not generally have a partnership between our brain and our body. We somehow see them as separate. We don't feel that connection. We don't see how our thoughts really affect our bodies, because they affect the way we feel and they affect the decisions we make. And when we're in the process of talking about weight and health, and if you're eating unhealthy foods, the decisions to put healthy foods in your body are decisions that are made because of your brain. So we want to make a partnership. You know, our bodies, we can be so unkind to our bodies. We're so critical of our bodies, and it's a societal thing. It's not like an individual thing. It is very much that's kind of, you know, if you look at any newscaster even, and they are perfect in their makeup, in their hair, and in their bodies. And so we often compare ourselves to other people, and we're not happy with our bodies. And yet, our bodies are mothers, our bodies are workers, our bodies get us to work, they get us to care for people. Our bodies are fantastic, right? They can do so much, and they can take so much abuse. And so I want to start with really the idea of a partnership, a love between your brain and your body, and that knowing how your brain works and knowing how your body works is going to be a tool that you can use for everything that you do or everything that you want to accomplish in your life. Because your thoughts really create your feelings, and those feelings, again, they motivate what it is you do or you don't do. So a lot of clients come to me and they are really terrified of hunger. Like somehow there has been a disconnect between our bodies and this idea that we can withstand hunger, and that hunger is going to be so painful that we can't even imagine going without food. And we're not talking for long periods of time. We're talking maybe for hours, right? And so usually 4 to 6 meals between 4 to 6 hours between each meal, it's not really a long time. And yet sometimes we just, that fear, which is part of a thought that is created about, I can't do it, I can't survive, or it's going to be too painful. And so I think that the fear of hunger is like a fear of your own body, a fear of the responses that you will have when you are hungry. And it's so interesting because our bodies were created to withstand hunger. I mean, that's the amazing thing. That's how we can lose weight and how we can be healthy, is because we have evolved in a time when there was lots of food during certain periods of the year, and then there was not a lot of food at other periods of time. And so your body would store fat. And then when there were times of not a lot of food, your body would eat or dine in, which is what we call. So your body has a great ability to withstand hunger, and for hunger then to lead to eating the stores of fat that you have in your body. So it sounds simple, but what's the problem? I'd like to break it down into three different types of hunger. Now, first we have emotional hunger, which I've talked about. You know, it's basically when you are trying to avoid an emotion, when you don't want to feel sad, or you don't want to feel anger, you don't want to deal with your life. So you're trying to avoid an emotion, you're trying to distract yourself from a problem, and so you eat and eat and eat. And that kind of hunger is really more of an urge. It's experienced as almost like uncontrollable, like your body is taking over. So in order to deal with emotional hunger, again, it's not really because you need food. It's not a hunger of nutrition, right? Which is the way your body is set up. Your body is set up to burn the nutrition that you eat, and then when it's empty, it needs more energy for fuel. So it needs more food, or it needs to burn fat as energy from your body. So emotional hunger is another way that we end up defeating ourselves in terms of weight loss or healthy living goals. And then the other big one is toxic hunger, and I've been learning a lot about toxic hunger. And so this is a big one. A lot of people experience this, and it kind of scares them. It's interesting. So it's lightheadedness, real irritability, being very tired, And what else? And headaches. So there's a lot of people what these symptoms are is actually your body's response to toxic foods. So if you are eating a lot of processed food, a lot of high sugar food, a lot of concentrated food, then what's happening is your body is responding and it's attempting to detoxify from this food that it's receiving in order to, again, to bring you to health. That's exactly what it's trying to do. And the other thing about toxic hunger, when we are eating foods that are non-nutritious, what happens is, it's amazing, is actually your body is driven to eat more calories than it even needs. So it is this idea of the brain and the reward that you're getting, right? It's not about hunger. It's the brain getting a reward, that dopamine from that pleasure. And the more pleasure it receives, the more it wants. And even though there's no nutrition going into your body, it still craves and wants more and more and more. So it's setting up really, and this is the idea of understanding how your brain and your body work. If you're going to eat foods that are non-nutritious, then you can expect your body to hold on to fat and to crave more food and to crave more of the negative. It's kind of like if you put other than gas in your car and expecting your car to run when you know that gas is what runs in your car, and that's what's going to get you faster to the place. So the thing is that, you know, when we look at the world, it's everywhere. Food is everywhere. Our modern society has changed to the fact that all of the things that drive us, the brain to seek pleasure, right? That's part of our survival, seek pleasure. That's what we needed to survive. Only now the pleasure we seek is just, it's more than we need, and it's disturbing the hormonal balances in our body, and it's creating obesity and then all of the lifestyle diseases that are killing us. It is amazing that 70% of Americans are now considered overweight, and that's really a big change over the past 50, maybe 20 to 30 years. So toxic hunger is a big reason. You can see that if you are consuming this kind of food, you're kind of stuck in this hamster wheel, right? Because the more you